those who are in tune. 3 days ago, my mind was very disturbed for a few minutes. Then I saw Gangaji, I saw her flowing, and all the trash that was thrown by people on her banks. Questions raised in my mind, why she who is so pure came down and has to deal with all the dirt. In spite of all trash and pollution, how does she feel? Does she feel dirty? She never feels dirty. Only for the people who are onlookers, they feel dirty. She never feels dirty. What is her state of mind? She doesn't have any state of mind because she doesn't have mind. She is in no mind. I feel she is the answer for my problems. The dirt inside me, I don't know when and if it will all go away. I pray to her to give me a state of mind, to remain pure in spite of all dirt. Can you please explain Gangaji's state of mind and how can I achieve it? Gangaji's state of mind cannot be explained because she is in no mind state. I can say how to achieve it. How to achieve it is only one way, one word: be unclutched. That's all. Do we all enter human bodies 45 minutes before the birth, or it was different in your individual case? Let me explain. Shana means gap between one thought and the other thought. If you have lived a meditative mood, in a meditative mood, your shana can be even 10 years. Even 10 years you can be without thought. If you have lived a restless life, your shana will be microsecond. For me, when I was settling into the body, my chana was, the three chana was 45 minutes. That was the ratio with which I was settling into the body. That is why it took 45 minutes for me. For a normal human being, three chana is less than a second. The touching the body, feeling the body, and settling into the body, completely possessing the body. That was the process. That's why, to make more aware and understanding, I can say three chana. And I can say that is the three frame I saw Swamiji. First, the light of the Arunachala, then being sucked into the light, and seeing the Arunachala. The three frame which I said, that only took three chanas, Swamiji. Three chanas, that only took 45 minutes. See, what I am saying you now, I am just retrieving the black box and giving you the exact picture of what happened. Like in the plane accidents, plane crashes, they will retrieve the black box and take the information out. Same way, I retrieved the black box of my birth and I am giving you as it happened. That is the way it happened. Maybe the further explanation, even I may not be able to give. Maybe more and more contemplating on it will bring the further explanation. This is the three frames for me. First, the light in that South India area. The second, just being sucked into that light by a force. One more thing. That's a beautiful verse. Arunachala. It says, Adi Nadam Adu Malai, Andri River, Vedu Malai, Sodiya, Adavan, Joodu Malai, Needith Adaikku Malai, Jnanat Thabodhanarai, Vava Vendra Adaikku Malai, Anna Malai. Let me translate that word. That hill is a place where Adi, the existence, lives, and the divine resides, and the great science of enlightenment, Dharma, spreads. That is the hill, so powerful to pull enlightened masters from any zone. Jnana Thabodhanarai Vava Vendra Adaikku Malai. The enlightened beings will be just pulled, sucked by the hill to the planet Earth. It's like, you see, if the TV station, many things are relayed, programs are all relayed. In your house, you should have a dish to pull that information. Something like that. On the planet Earth, they created few dishes to pull the enlightened masters. Again and again to planet Earth. See this, our Vedic rishis, these rishis, they were afraid that this living tradition of enlightened masters will die in the planet Earth. So they created few dish antennas everywhere. So that constantly these guys will be sucked to the planet Earth, pulled to the planet Earth. The planet Earth will not miss the living science of enlightenment. So it's one, Arunachala is one of the important dish. Satellite center created by masters to pull the living masters to planet Earth. That's why they say, Jnana Thabodhanarai Vava Vendra Adaikku Malai. ஆதினட மாடுமலை அன்றிருவர் ஏடுமலை சோதியாட அரவன் ஜூடுமலை நீதி தழைக்குமலை ஞானத்தபோதனரை வாவென்று அழைக்குமலை அண்ணாமலையே. So it just pulls the three scene only I saw. One, the light in southern India. The second just being pulled. The third, Arunachala. Third, complete the hill. Means already the body has happened. These three chana only took 45 minutes. That only took 45 minutes. With that vibration or that frequency only this body has happened. I never had the idea there is a two thing like enlightened and unenlightened. Never had the idea there is something called enlightenment, there is something called unenlightenment. So I never had the idea. Another one thing Swamiji, with a 24 karat gold you can never make jewelry. Add a little copper, make jewelry. After making jewelry, if you put that jewelry into the acid, copper will melt away, only gold will stay. Now you will have 24 karat gold jewelry. Same way, with a pure sattvic quality, pure energy, you can't make body. Add a little tamas and rajas, make the body. Once you make the body, put that body into the acid of tapas for 10-12 years. It will, the copper, the rajas and tamas and the dirt will go away. Now the pure 24 karat gold jewelry. That is the process actually happens. That is the process of enlightened master taking birth, doing tapas and getting enlightened. That is the process of energy assuming the body and doing tapas and becoming again energy. Because the purification process of whatever little bit was added to create the body has to be cleaned. That only took the tapas time. That only took the tapas time. Ramakrishna says, the rope, ordinary rope can be used to tie. If you burn the rope, that rope will look, after burning it will look like a rope. It can never tie anybody. It can never tie anybody. So whatever you think as anger, all those qualities will disappear in master's anger. Whatever you think as lust, all those qualities will disappear in master's lust. Whatever you think as infatuation, all those qualities will disappear in master's infatuation. Whatever you think as greed, all those qualities will disappear in master's greed. So it can never neither bind him nor bind others. It's a burnt rope. That is why when people come and tell me, Swamiji, when Vivekananda was smoking and drinking, why not me? Vivekananda used to drink. And even now, if you go to the Vivekananda's temples, means the shrines maintained by Vivekananda, they will offer all kinds of champagne and everything. Even now, all the different kinds of cigarette and everything they will offer. Because he used to drink and smoke. People come and ask me, when he did, why not we? Be very clear, he became enlightened, then did. You also became enlightened. Then smoke or then drink. We cannot compare their activity and our activity. That's a beautiful Zen saying. Zen master says, one Zen master, he is a chain smoker. He will go on advising people, don't smoke, don't smoke, don't smoke. Then somebody asks the Zen master, you are a chain smoker and you go on advising us not to smoke. What is this? Then he says, I am not in the same plane to whom I am advising. You have to elevate. I have to bring me down. You have to be a jinnah, means conqueror. I have to be avatara, coming down. See, conquering is different and coming down is different. You have to be a, you have to conquer, you have to go up, elevate yourself. I have to bring myself down. If you start bringing yourself down, where you can go down more? Where else you can go now? Already down, down, down. Where else you can take yourself? That's why, beautifully there's a beautiful sense saying, do what masters say, not what they do. Do what they say, not what they do. Because, you see one thing, I always tell people, don't, when you eat food, don't read newspaper, don't see TV, don't do anything else. If you see me eating, actually the people who serve me, they know, the moment they serve food for me, they have to get something to divert my attention. Means some paper, or some book, or something they have to get. If I In your case, I say, be attentive when you eat. In my case, I always divert my attention, otherwise food will not go inside. The moment I am conscious, only living will go inside and it will stop. It will stop. That's why the moment I start eating, I'll have somebody to talk to me or somebody, some newspaper. The newspaper which I would have read for 10 times. I'll take up the newspaper and start reading from the same line. With awareness, you will take only less quantity of food. In your case, you need to reduce. Otherwise, body will unnecessarily overload itself because of the taste. In my case, the taste has lost its effect on me. The people who take care of me, ask them, they will tell you, to open my mouth is like a opening the... It's a big job. It's not that I'm doing purposely. I myself don't feel like it. It becomes a big job even for me to open. Because the taste has lost its control over me. Because of that, I have to force me to eat. I have to divert the attention to some other direction to eat. So what I am doing is complete opposite to what I am saying to you two. I am saying you eat with awareness. In my case, only when I eat, I will try my best to divert my awareness. I tell them, I will play this music. I will bring the newspaper. I will call somebody to talk to me. I will do something. Only then, even two or three more hands will go inside. Otherwise, don't go inside.
Can we compare Tiruvannamalai with Himalaya?
Yes, surely. There is no need to compare. Actually, all dishes are one and the same. There is no need to compare. Different dishes established by different masters. That's all. It's all one and the same. There is no need to compare. To tell you honestly, my body was somehow trained by because of the yoga. It constantly produces the chemicals, whatever it is necessary for the body to run. It is running. It is actually, if the same way if it runs, how long it will run? For that reason only I try to give food. You understand? For emergency time, whenever it is necessary, if the body manages itself, beautiful. If I allow that same thing like a regular routine, it may have the wear and tear. The automatic managing system may have wear and tear. That's why I try to give the food and try to encourage try to supply the whatever necessary for the body. That's what is I am trying to do.
To attain enlightenment, if one must do strong tapas, dhyanam, etc., like how you did, Swamiji, is there any other enlightened masters who adopted some other techniques to attain the same? Meera became enlightened just by singing. You said you had no karma at birth. This automatically places you as an incarnation of consciousness. For what purpose and this? What purpose this incarnation take place? One thing did this incarnation take place. This is an important thing. When a cotton is processed to a certain extent only, it becomes thread. Then you can say one thread, two thread, three thread. When it is cotton itself, can you say how many threads are there inside the cotton? Same way, when my incarnation happened, the incarnation decision is taken in a cotton level. In the thread level only, you can say the purpose, reason, the logic and all those things. In cotton level, the very concept of purpose and reason doesn't exist. You understand? That's a big problem. Whenever people ask for reason and purpose, that where the decision is taken, there it was only playfulness, leela. There was no decision. There was no reason. There was no logic. There was no do's and don'ts there. In that space only decision is taken. The execution happens in a level where the reasons exist. Do's and don'ts, why, how, what, where, when. The execution happens in this level. But the decision making happened in a level where the why, what, how, why, what, where, when, then did not exist. In that level only the decision making happened. So now you are putting a question from execution level to the decision making level. I am not able to answer that because in the decision making level, this logic does not exist. Maybe that word is told in the execution level itself. for the you see somebody like you questioned Krishna. He must have tried his best to tell that decision making level there is no logic. The execution level only logic exists. That guy may not be able to relate with that truth. What I am saying, Krishna also may not have remembered the example like a cotton and the thread. So then he has to answer something. Then he said, Paritranaya sadhuna minajaya kashukudara dharma samstavanarthaya sambhavanam yuge yuge. Alright, now tell me, even with this sloka, what do you understand? Paritranaya sadhuna minajaya kashukudara dharma samstavanarthaya sambhavanam yuge yuge. Paritranaya sadhuna, there is no definition. Who is sadhu? Whoever wins in the war, they claim themselves as sadhu. If the Adler, Hitler, Adolf Hitler, if you would have won in the war, history would have been different. So now we say he is the Dushta. How do we know he is Dushta? If he has won in the war, what would have been the history? Incarnation. He would have been incarnation. So where is the question of definition for sadhu? Second thing, where is the question of definition of the Dushta? And where is the question of all these, the basic thing itself is gone now. Paritranaya sadhuna, vinachaya cha dushkritam. These two has lost the meaning. Then third, dharma samstavanarthaya. What is dharma? Tell me. Now what will you say? What is dharma? Dharma samstavanarthaya. Which dharma? Sambhavami, yuge yuge. Sambhavami, what is the difference? Sambhavami means I happen. Yuge yuge means what he means by the word yuga yuga. 10 years or 20 years or 100 years or 700 years or 900 years, what happens? Where is the definition for yuga yuga? If it is, yuga cannot be more than at least 1000 years. And already 5000 years over. This fellow never came back. Never returned. Now what to do? Huh? He has escaped. Whether he is frightened or not, we don't know. What to do now? So those words also is given just to make the people feel comfortable. That's all. Let it be very clear. I am telling you the truth as it is. The decision which is made to enter into the body is taken in a plane where the how, why, what, these, that logic did not have any play. See, to after a certain level, even in your own life, you see, when you are in ecstasy, joyful, when you are in ecstasy, you don't take decisions by thinking. Just like that you take. So in that high energy zone, the decision does not happen by logical analyzing pros and cons and plans and thinking and what will happen with this, with that. That does not happen. Seed opening up and becoming flower. That, just like that. That's what they say. Swabhava Chinmayananda. Just the Chinmayananda. Just the bliss. Swabhava. There is no reason, logic. So that is the zone, the decision to take birth has happened. So now in the execution level only, the logic of 1, 2, 3 and all those things happens. So this question can never be answered because the decision itself is taken in a different play. Ah, yes.
Intuition.
Intuition.
There is no logic.
There is no logic behind it. Paritranaya sadhunam vinasaya dushkritam dharma samstavanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge. Whenever too many engrams became in your head, whenever you start suffering with too many engrams, to destroy them and to give you enlightenment, to take care of your being and to establish enlightenment in you, I come down again and again and teach MSP. That's all. Now with the higher level meaning, were you aware of other beings and other karmas before your birth? No. Before birth, I was not. You see, I was aware of everything, but not as separately. See, to be aware of a cloud, you must know the silver lining. I was aware of clouds, but not the silver linings. When you are not aware of the silver linings, then the whole thing is a cloud. So that is where it was standing. So after birth only, I became aware of silver linings. All the information you are giving us is appreciated. How do I know it for myself? How do I understand? the very appreciation means you have started drinking me. You have started drinking me. This very drinking is enough. It will become Ahara Suddhi. Ahara Suddha Yoho Smriti Suddhi. Smriti Suddha Yoho. It goes up step by step and reaches the enlightenment. Be very clear. That's why we say when a river is completely polluted, if you just drop one handful of lime in it, the lime will take all the dust and settle down. Same way, when you are completely confused by the world and the engram and the society, one handful of master's presence is a lime, or the words of the master is a lime. When you drop that, it just settles down completely, you become pure. So allow this sinking to happen and happen and happen. Allow this drinking to happen. Simply you will see, suddenly one day you are again completely clear. If and when I became enlightened, I will say I had no karma, because that is the Vedantic truth. But what you said, that you know you had no karma at birth, looks different. Please clarify. If your statement is also a declaration of final Vedantic truth, or your declaration is different from my declaration if I am enlightened. When you became enlightened and declared that you never had a karma, that is the same way I am declaring. Be very clear. If I am not enlightened now, I will say I have karma. So be very clear, when you became enlightened and declare, that is the same way I am declaring. That is the same way I am declaring. I am no way special when I declare I have no karma or all those things. Now what you are going through, I went through in that same period. Between the, I can say 0 to 12 years, actually, to tell you honestly, after the first experience, so I became enlightened. But that looks too big to tell openly. To tell that looks too big. That's the reason I go on saying it was 22. After the first experience itself is an enlightenment. After that, I kept a little bit of mind to play with all sorts of techniques to create the technology for human beings. The reproduction. To the system to reproduce, for that only I took 10 years. The enlightenment experience itself happened 12. After 12, there was no suffering at all, completely no suffering. But the 0 to 12, I also had the same problems what you are having now. Same confusion, ups and downs. That just the other day, David was asking, Swami, did you have ups and downs? I had ups and downs, let me be very clear. I was suffering and I tried even suicide. So let it be very clear, I had ups and downs. When I speak about biography, I will speak about all those things. I had ups and downs, I had all problems which you are having now. So when I say all, I mean A-L-L.